What's up, everybody? Jared here, and we have another tractor video. This is part of a build series for my new Kubota L3560 limited edition hydrostat cab tractor. And in this video, we're going to show the Kubota top and tilt kit that I purchased for my tractor. Now, in order to use this, I'm sure you already know, but you got to have rear remotes. So the part number for this kit is an L8388A top and tilt kit. Fits the Grand L and MX series tractors. But imagine this is going to be a pretty easy and straightforward installation, but we'll take a look at the destruction manuals anyways. Tractor preparations, remove top link, lifting rod, left and place in storage. Remove lift rod, right, install in place of item 2 and figure 1. So obviously top link 1, we're removing. Number 2, the lifting rod left. Okay, so I was a little confused here. I didn't understand why it wanted me to remove the lifting rod left and place it in storage, because usually put the tilt cylinder on the right hand side. But now I understand. They're wanting you to remove the right hand, which is the adjustable lifting rod, and we're going to install that on the left hand side. So getting rid of the top link, removing the non-adjustable left lift rod, putting it in storage, taking the right adjustable lift rod, moving it over here. Install hoses and couplers, and noted in figure 2. Install the top cylinder into the hole from where item number 1 was removed. Cylinder should be oriented so the stroke rod will move away from the tractor and the hoses are facing up. Install tilt cylinder to the right hand lower link, and hoses should be facing away from the tractor. Install couplers, which we will do all of that before we install it. Figure 3 notes lever functions. Check respective rear remote hydraulic manual to be sure your model's the same. All hoses in the kit are the same length. Item 9 is the rear remote. Apply Teflon tape to the NPT fittings. Position X is recommended if the height of your drawbar is less than 15 inches from the ground. Position Y is recommended if the height of your drawbar is more than 15 inches from the ground. Position X will lift the implement higher. It will not allow the tilt cylinder to drop the implement as much. Position Y would do the opposite. Adjust the pin accordingly. Okay, so let's assemble these guys. So since this has the two pins, this is obviously the tilt. one of these O-ring fittings, if you don't know. You take the fitting and drive it down to where it's snug and almost tight, and then back it off to the direction you need to go and tighten a nut on top. That draws the O-ring down and seals it up, but allows it to lock in whatever place you want. That's the super nice advantage of an O-ring fitting. Can't quite go that full last turn, so we back it off and tighten it up there. We may find we want to adjust these once we get these in the tractor, depending upon where the hydraulic hoses are and where we want them to be. And I can already see, I think I'm going to need these angled at least a little bit, so this one does not impede with that. Matter of fact, I'm going to go ahead and loosen both these up. I'm going to be using thread sealant with PTFE. This is a great sealant for hydraulic fittings. Make sure you don't get any inside. Okay, now those are installed. Set this one aside and assemble the other one. Always lubricate your O-rings. That'll allow them to slide in place so they don't bind up or kink. Yeah, I think I changed my mind. I'm gonna leave the hoses off of this and install this first. Then I'll put the hoses on and figure out how I want them routed and what direction all the fittings need to go. We will, however, go ahead and get the fittings installed on the Pioneer couplers installed.